Alright, Shalom and Makim, all praises to Yahweh, Basha Mount Shai. Alright, double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone, and peace and blessings to you brothers out there doing the work in truth and sincerity. Alright, I got this brother here with me. We just gonna roll through the spirit. We got a precept that we wanna bring out, and then we gonna elaborate on the precept, and then however the spirit moves it, we gonna continue in the video. So go ahead, bring out the scripture.
This is Job 12 and 16. With him is strength and wisdom. The deceived and the deceiver are his.
Yeah, the deceived and the deceiver are his. Now, I brought this up for a particular reason because, especially in Israel right now, you got a lot of these scoffers and scorners coming against the men of the Lord that actually, you know, that are actually pushing the truth, they're actually pushing the right doctrine. And what these guys don't understand is that they're being deceived. All right? So they're being deceived by Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right? Okay? And the Lord said the deceived and the deceiver are his. So the people that are being deceived, all right, by Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, that are going out and deceiving other people, other men, all right, other men and women that believe on their false doctrines, philosophies, the Most High is setting that all up. Because what you have to understand is that the Most High, he has the election. All right, and there's an election according to how the Most High set it up. All right, if you Romans 9 tells you about that. All right, let's get that. Get Romans 9. When you have something before, hold that. Bring out what you got. I'll bring it out.
Okay,
go ahead.
It's Jeremiah 5:31. The prophets prophesy falsely, and the priests bear rule by their means.
Yeah, the prophets prophesy falsely. Because these guys that make videos, all right, and come against brothers, they're false prophets, man. They're opening up the scriptures. Once you open up the scriptures and try to teach, all right, you're basically putting on that title as a teacher, as a prophet.
Yeah.
All right.
Even if you don't want to, you say that you're not a prophet yet, you're claiming to know the truth and know the difference between right and wrong in the scriptures. So you're off top of prophet.
You're off top of prophet, and that's why we brought the scripture to deceive, and the deceiver are his. All right, you guys are being deceived. All right, you scoffers and scorners, you're being deceived to believe that you're going to make it, that the Lord is actually with you. All right, but it's Satan that's in your mind. All right, and giving you all these different thoughts, these wicked thoughts. All right, to come against the men of the Lord. All right, and to push forth heresies, man, it's things that are not ought to be taught in the scriptures. Okay, go ahead.
The prophets prophesy falsely, and the priests bear rule by their means, and my people love to have it
and
so.
And my people love to have it so. Oh, good job. Well, I'm glad you left the coat. I'm glad. Oh, great video. Oh, this is food. All right. It says my people love it so, man. They love to hear these. They love to hear smooth words. They love to hear that everything's going to be all right. They love to hear that, hey, you can do all this wickedness. The Lord still loves you. All right. That the Lord is going to be with you, man. And that's not so, man. You're being deceived. All right, the majority of our people are being deceived by Satan, man. They're being deceived by Satan to think that they're going to continue on and on forever, and that their counsel is going to stand. All right, but the Lord, he's sending deceiving spirits out there for you guys to think and believe a lie, man. To believe a lie that you're going to make it, man. And you guys are going to be destroyed. All right, the Lord set you guys up to be destroyed. Okay.
All right. Another.
All right. You gonna bring that and then get Ezekiel the 13th chapter, yeah. 2. Go ahead.
It's Proverbs 14:12. There is a way which seemeth right unto a man.
Oh man, there is a way that seemeth right unto a man. All right. By your own heart, your own lust of the heart, just because you feel that what you're doing is correct and what you're doing is right. There's a way that seemeth right unto a man. Read. Continue.
But the end thereof are the ways of death.
But the end thereof are the ways of death, man. All right, the scriptures and the truth, this is life. What you guys are doing, that you guys believe that what you're doing is correct, that's death, man. All right, what you guys are doing is a death lifestyle. All right, what you guys should be doing is actually going out there and teaching the word, man. Going out there teaching the word instead of scoffing and scorning. You guys don't even examine yourself to say, okay, what am I doing? All I do is make videos and talk shit, man. You guys don't even you don't even meditate on the fact if you're doing the work or not. It says examine yourself, whether you be in the faith, man.
Yeah.
You guys are not examining yourselves.
They really just freestyling it, because you don't even care about, you got to do, like, the dude Hugh, you say, I probably went off, but it's all for, it's so you can learn not to be like me. You shouldn't be going off in the first place. Somebody should be correcting you when you do go off, but you niggas in your weak-ass adventure group, y'all not going to correct each other. One person could be teaching the complete opposite of what you believe, but you're not even going to rebuke him on it. You're going to let him teach whatever he want to teach, as long as y'all come together against Great Millstone. That's all that matters to y'all.
Hey, man, Huey, you're going to be, the Lord's going to destroy you, man. All right, Yashar and Avengers, the Lord's going to destroy you guys. He's going to destroy you and your whole family and your household, man. All right, you guys are totally gone. You guys are totally gone, all right? The Lord's going to come, and he's going to destroy you. Go ahead, I.
You want Ezekiel?
Yeah, get Ezekiel. Start at 1.
13:1?
Yep.
Yep. Ezekiel 13:1, and the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel.
Prophesy against the prophets of Israel. The brother just brought up the scriptures, man, that basically you prophesy falsely in the name of the Lord. Oh, Yahweh Bashimi, I was shy. Oh, all praises to the elect.
Even if that may not be the right name.
Yeah,
you're still going to say it.
You're still going to say it, man.
Doubting the name. You're calling on a name that you doubt.
Yeah, you guys are bug outs, man. You guys are bug outs. To the men that are worthy of salvation. Who are these guys? Who are these guys?
Scripturally.
Who are these guys that are worthy of salvation? You must be talking about the elect. Now the elect were going to be found doing something. All right. The scriptures say, "Blessed is he that when I come in, I find so doing, basically doing these commands." We can get that next. I'll get it in Revelation. Revelation, I believe, 22. Okay, you know what? Yeah, do that. Yeah, it's a different verse, too. Hold on.
Oh, you want me
to go ahead and bring that? Finish out in Ezekiel.
Ezekiel 13:2, Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel that prophesy, and say thou unto them that prophesy out of their own hearts, hear ye the word of the Lord.
So when we come again, when we rebuke you guys, we're doing it out of the scriptures. This is what the scriptures say. It says, hear ye. We supposed to prophesy against you guys, man. All you false ass prophets. Go ahead.
Thus saith the Lord, power, woe unto the foolish prophets.
Destruction. That's what we're saying. Woe unto you guys. Woe unto Hugh Razzie. Woe unto Yashar, formerly known as Yashar Mafba. Okay. Woe unto the two hearts. Alright, Yakanan, alright, woe unto all you false ass teachers, man. Woe unto you false ass prophets, man. Destruction unto you, death unto you, alright. We praise Yahweh Bashimah Shai, and we send up curses on you guys, man. Alright, to destroy you and your household. Why? Because you're teaching, because the scriptures say so, man. Alright, the scriptures say mark them that cause division, and you guys are causing massive amount of division within Israel, which this is all set up by the spirit of Yahweh Bashimah Shai, are to weed away the undesirables. All right, continue.
Thus saith the Lord, power, woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit.
That follow their own spirit instead of humbling down. All right, and being taught by men that have the spirit with them. You feel that you want to teach the way that you want to, like Huey. All right, Huey, you totally out of order, man. Right, and brothers rebuked you, man. Brothers rebuked you. You were making videos, all right, that had no edification, and you just talking out of your mouth, man. That's some bullshit, all right. You a guy like you need to get put to death, and a guy like you is going to get put to death, all right. We don't personally hate you per se because who you are, all right, because you teaching nothing but heresies, man. You're prophesying and you're speaking out of your own heart. You have nothing. Basically, you teaching nothing but straight just abominations, man. And you know you are too. You go, I know I don't know a lot, but I'm just gonna continue reading. You just read something. You learning as you go. No, the scriptures say. He told Ezekiel. Get Ezekiel. I believe it's the second chapter, real quick. And he said. Where he says, eat the roll. I believe it's, is it two or three, or the third chapter? That's where it's.
Open thy mouth and eat that I give thee. Well, it's probably one.
Hold on. Yeah, it's right here. Yeah, it's coming. Two. Yeah, okay. Start at the top.
Yep, Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 1. Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest, eat this roll.
And eat the whole roll, God damn it. All right, you guys eating, you taking off a little piece. All right, what you like, the roll. Yeah, it looks good, but I'm just going to take a part that I want. And you're just going to cast off everything else. No, you're supposed to eat this roll. Go ahead.
Eat this roll and go speak unto the house of Israel.
Yeah, you're supposed to eat this roll, eat the scriptures, meaning digest and digest the understanding of the scriptures, which you have to be taught by men. Okay? Go ahead.
So I opened my mouth, and he caused me to eat that roll. And he said unto me, son of man, cause thy belly to eat, and fill thy bowels with this roll that I give thee. Then did I eat it, and it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness. And he said unto me, son of man, go get thee into the house of Israel.
So he ate the whole roll, man. Go get thee into the house of Israel. So that's when you're not supposed to, I'm just going to make videos in my car. I'm just going to make videos. This is my lot. No, it said go and get thee unto the children of Israel. Go ahead.
And speak with my words
unto them. Speak with my words. The words of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Go back to, is that it on that?
Yep.
Yeah, go back to the Ezekiel, the 13th chapter. Speak with my words, all right? Not your own words, man. We can't speak. We can't just come out of here and come out of our own heart, man. This is not how it goes down, all right? This is the word of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, and you have to teach it according to the way he set it up, all right? And he set up men to be teachers, all right? He set up men to be teachers, the apostles and elders. What? To teach the other brothers, and brothers want to come up to be teachers, okay? Go ahead,
You want to start?
Yeah, continue where you were at.
Okay. All right. Thus saith the Lord power, Ezekiel 13:3. Thus saith the Lord power, woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit and have seen nothing.
And have seen nothing, man. And have seen nothing. These guys don't. I'm waking up and I feel niggas are talking about me. I open up scriptures and it doesn't say that. It doesn't say that.
What about the love scriptures?
Yeah, what about the love scriptures? God is love. You guys come in the spirit of Christianity. You're really coming in the spirit of a bitch. All right? All that damn love, man. Which love is the keeping of the commandments, which you guys don't keep the commandments. Yeah. All right?
You try to be on that definition of love that Esau pushes. You don't stick to what love is according to the scriptures. You want to stick to the love that Esau says. Hugging everybody. Love beats hates. Love wins. That's the hype that y'all want. You want all of us to come together. But it's not supposed to be like that. The Lord didn't come for everybody to come together. He came for division.
Yeah, the Lord came for division, man. Continue on.
Oh, Israel, thy prophets are like the foxes in the deserts.
Yeah, they're like the foxes in the deserts, man. Just sly, slick creatures, man. All right, wicked. All right, go ahead.
Ye have not gone up into the gaps. Neither made up the hedge for the house of Israel to stand in the battle in the day of the Lord.
Yeah, you're not preparing Israel for the battle in the day of the Lord, meaning when Yahweh Shai comes back, he's going to come back and he's going to find out who has that wedding garment on, who has that pound, who has that talent, all right? And he's going to find out, we'll get that word says, blessed is the man who should, when I find him doing the, you know, in Luke 12. When Yahweh Shai comes back, are you doing the work? Are you going to be on a toilet doing a sit-down, bringing out Dragon Ball Z, and trying to break down the scriptures using Dragon Ball Z? Or are you just going to be a groovy out of your damn mind, just talking shit, doing challenges, man? Gospel challenges. Oh, find me one video where there's not hate, envy, strife. And that's all you niggas display is hate, envy, strife, deceit, yeah. Revelings.
Bearing false witness, as you niggas would talk about. You don't have any proof. You're just talking. You said that the apostles don't know you personally or anybody personally. You don't know them personally. So why are you speaking about them? You're just a demon.
You guys are demons, man. Alright? You guys are demons. And the Lord's going to destroy you. Go ahead,
It's Luke 12 and 43. Blessed is that servant whom his Lord, when he cometh, shall find so doing.
Find so doing what? Doing what, man? Doing the work. Go ahead.
Of a truth, I say unto you, that he will make him ruler over all that he has.
So a man that's actually doing the work of Yahweh Bashemal Shai, well, first and foremost, you got to come out of the correct, you got to come with the correct doctrine. All right, you have to have the correct doctrine, all right, and you have to eat the whole roll, man. You have to know the whole entirety of the scriptures. And then what do? You go out and you teach, man. All right, you go out and you suffer for Yahweh Shai's sake. All right, and then when Yahweh Shai comes back, when he gets, lock in. I'll be right back.
Yeah, blesses that servant when he's trying to find so doing, man. And you guys ain't doing nothing but just sitting on your ass coughing.
Yeah, when Yahweh Shai comes back to be, and when he comes back to get his kingdom, he's gonna be glorified. You're gonna be joint heirs. But you guys are gonna be destroyed, all right? You're gonna catch the famine, all right? You're gonna catch the pestilences. All right, wild animals gonna be attacking you. Leviathan's gonna be coming out of the sea, out of the waters. All right, shooting fire on you guys. All right, Esau, Uncle Esau, he gonna come. He gonna break down your door, rape your woman. All right, rape your little son. All right, terrible times are coming to you, scoffers and your scorners. All right, but the deceived and the deceiver are his, man. Yahweh Bashemal Shai is the one who's really setting all this up. He sent you guys up for a great failure, man. Just like Esau, he's getting set up for a great failure. The two thirds, primarily the two thirds that know that they're Israelites, you're gonna get a heavier judgment. Yeah. All right, the ones that took on that, like, all right, I'm gonna follow Yahweh Shai, I'm gonna carry my cross, and then you guys gave up. You're gonna receive a greater damnation. All right, the scripture says it's impossible for them that were once enlightened. All right, go ahead. I think that was almost pretty much it. Go ahead.
But and if that servant say in his heart, my Lord delayeth his coming,
and that's what you guys did, and that's what you guys are doing.
Yeah.
All right, you saying, read that again, I.
But and if that servant say in his heart, my Lord delayeth his coming.
My Lord delayeth his coming. And that's what you guys doing. You guys are, I'm tired of catching hell. All this hate. All this envy. Why do I gotta hate everybody? Why can't I just love?
Why do I gotta hate my life?
Why do I have to hate my life? Alright? You guys are reprobates, man. You guys basically put a time limit on when the Lord was supposed to come back. Continue.
My Lord delayeth his coming and shall begin to beat the men's servants.
And you didn't need that? What you got? Bro, this is what these guys are doing.
Yeah.
They literally want to kill the servants. They were once doing the work. Then they stopped because, oh, the Lord, he ain't coming back. Oh, it could be 10, 20, 30 years. I could have went to college. I could have had all this type of fun. I gave my life away and the Lord didn't even come back. Then now you're mad at the Lord, man. Since you can't beat the Lord, you would literally try to kill Yahweh Shai if he was here. Which you guys did that in the reincarnation.
Yeah.
But now, since Yahweh Shai is not here, who's here? The servants of Yahweh Shai that still believe, that still doing the work. You want to beat these. You want to kill them. And you got guys that say they want to kill the prophets, man.
Yep. The only reason you don't do it is because Esau's lost. If you wouldn't get in any trouble for it, niggas would be killing the prophets right now.
Right this second. And what you guys are doing right now, you're trying to basically get accusations against different men that's out there doing the work, that's actually out there on the highways and the byways. Because I'm going to keep pushing that. You guys don't go out on the highways and the byways, all right?
Yeah.
I'm going to keep pushing through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashemal Shai. I'm going to keep telling you guys, you don't go out and you're going to be destroyed, all right? And you're trying to put accusations on different brothers, and you're trying to put sick Esau on them, man. Because you know Esau has the power in right now in this kingdom. So you're trying to put, lock him up, or, you know,
Fire him from his job.
On some real bitch nigga shit, man. You on some real bitch nigga shit. All right? For real. And I ain't want to do so-called cursing. All right? But hey, man, you guys are bitches. Literally. Go ahead, all right.
My Lord delayeth his coming and shall begin to beat the men servants and maidens and to eat and drink and to be drunken.
To go back into the world, man. You guys left the work to go back into the world, all right? And a lot of you guys that never even did the work, you just a scoffer. You don't even have the balls to go out, all right?
You don't even show your face.
You don't even show. You're a mystery avenger.
It's probably the man. same. It's probably fucking Two Heart the whole time. Yeah, more than likely.
Yeah, under another alias.
Just being a bug out, making another page, trying to pretend that it's another guy that's part of your whack ass group when it's just you. You got two different. You like that one character, Two Face. That's your ass. You got so many different personalities, pretending to be other brothers. Like you got fans like that. The only reason people look at your videos is because it's just nothing but drama. And people like drama. That's why people watch Love & Hip Hop and all that other reality shows, because it's nothing but BS drama. And that's what you niggas trying to bring into Israel. Because you're not teaching anything edifying. Because if you let anybody make an edifying video, you don't get any views like that.
You don't get no views.
But when you're doing nothing but gossip, you're getting hits. And then you're going to make sure the title has a nice name so everybody can just be drawn to it. Because you niggas are demons.
That's right. That's right. Oh, I got a quick scripture before we continue. This is Matthew 11:6. And blessed is he whomsoever shall not be offended in me. You guys are offended in Yahweh Shai. That's why you guys don't show your face, man. That's why you on the comment boards, you know, under an alias or under different aliases or just scoffing. Nobody knows who you are. You can be a fucking 13-year-old girl in North Dakota somewhere, and we don't know. We don't know who you guys are because you're not standing boldly and firm to what you believe. You're just a damn scoffer. All right, go ahead.
Verse 46 in Luke 12. The Lord of that servant will come in a day when he looketh not for him.
Yeah, when you guys think that you're setting your plan, you're setting your scoffing. That's when the Lord gonna come. When you don't even know it. While the men of the Lord are actually watching for these prophecies, you're just really just watching. You got every brother's videos on alert that pop up on your phone, so you can be the first one to watch, so you'll be the first one to scoff. While you doing that, scoffing on the videos, all right, the Lord's going to come for your ass, and you're not going to even know. Lord, help me, Lord. I was doing the work. Then you're going to start, Yahweh Shai. And the Lord just gonna look at you like, this nigga, man. But off with the nigga's head.
Yeah. All right. Your nigga's gonna be scoffing, typing up a scoff on the comment board, and then FEMA troops kicking in your fucking door while you're trying to scoff in the midst of you typing.
Yeah, or a brother might just come through your screen. Might just have spiritual power just come through your screen. Like, yeah, nigga, what was all this stuff you talking about? You gonna bug, your heart gonna fail you, and you just probably gonna drop dead. The Lord gonna preserve you, man. The Lord gonna preserve you. You scoffers and scorners have the heaviest judgment, man.
Yep.
You have the heaviest judgment. You gonna get a man. You gonna get a very heavy judgment. Okay, go ahead, Art.
The Lord of that servant will come in a day when he looketh not for him, and at an hour when he is not aware.
Yeah, when you're not aware because you're not watching. You guys are not watching the prophecies. You're not watching for these things to come. You guys don't even speak about the kingdom. You guys don't even speak about the kingdom or trying to be saved. You don't even, like I'm trying to, you guys don't even do your scoffing in order to make it into the kingdom. I'm doing my scoffing. You know, you praying to the Lord. Lord, I'm coming against these men in hopes that I can make it out of America from the destruction. You guys are not even thinking about that, man. You guys literally have an empty life, man. You're just really just set up on a planet Earth to come against the prophets. And that's scary, man. That's scary. And you guys don't even know. And we tell you guys, hey, look, stop doing that. And you can't do it, man. You guys are being controlled, man. You're being controlled by Yahweh Shemal Shai, all right? We read it in Job 12, what, 12 and 16? The deceived and the deceiver are his, man. You guys are being deceived, all right? You being a deceived to believe a lie. And a lie is what? That this kingdom is going to continue on forever, and as you're going to be stable and concrete in your scoffing, man. And that's not so, because why? You want to stay in America because you know that your deeds are evil, man.
You can enjoy being wicked, but being a demon in America, Esau allows you to do whatever. You don't have to have any like we was going into last night. You don't have to have any discipline. You don't have to be in order. You don't have to be under anybody. You can just be a renegade demon. Do whatever you want.
Do whatever the hell you want to do. Go ahead.
The Lord of that servant. The Lord of that servant will come in a day when he looketh not for him, and at an hour when he is not aware, and will cut him in sunder, and will appoint him his portion with the unbelievers.
Yeah, portion. So you gonna get a judgment with the unbelievers, man. a heavy judgment, and a lot of that's going to be nuclear missiles. Are you going to be you're going to get caught up in a nuclear missile? And if you get saved from the nuclear missiles, the Lord really hated you, man.
Yep.
The Lord already hates you niggas, but he really hates you to get hit with a missile, man. And you guys don't even talk about the missiles. You guys do not talk about the destruction of America because you don't want America to be destroyed, like Trump. The destruction of America. All right. You guys don't want that. You guys really want to actually stay here. You guys want to stay here under Uncle Esau, all right, and have him molest your kids, have him poison the water, poison the air, poison the food. All right, give you vaccinations, all right, allow homosexuals to run rampant and transgender. You guys want to stay in a kingdom like this, man. You guys are not even smart enough to lead the country. You guys are not even smart enough. You should know that, hey, look, America's going to be destroyed. You guys are not even thinking about that. When you wake up in the morning, the thought of America being destroyed is not in your mind. The thought in your mind is, I got to get these niggas in GMS. I gotta get him. I hate him. I hate him. I want to kill him. You got some more on that?
No, that was it on that.
Yeah, just we'll wrap it up on John 8:44. Bubba Gashaw. All right, because you guys are doing the work of Satan. All right, you guys are doing the work of Satan, and Satan deceiving you guys, man. Satan deceiving you guys. Go ahead, Op.
This is John 8:44. That's a lot. John 8:44. Ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning.
Talking about Esau, continue.
And abode not in the truth.
Yeah, abode not in the truth. You guys didn't abode in the truth. You guys fell out of the truth. Go ahead, continue.
Because there is no truth in him.
There is no truth in you guys. Go ahead.
When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own.
So when you guys make accusations against the prophets of the Lord, you're talking about yourself. Because you're like, he can't be holy. Because I'm wicked. I lie, I cheat, I commit adultery. You know? Oh, he can't do, he's doing the same thing. He's doing the same thing. So when you guys are actually making these videos coming against the men saying, accusing them of all these different things, it's because you're doing it, man. Go continue.
For he is a liar and the father of it.
Yeah, you guys are goddamn liars, man. And just like your daddy Esau, alright? Just like your daddy Esau, you ride along with Esau, man. You hand in hand. It's you niggas, man. The whole time Esau's doing exactly what he's supposed to do.
Yep.
It's you niggas that's fucking it up, man. Alright? Because you are bold, not in the truth, alright? And everything in your mind, everything that comes into your head is a lie, man. Everything that you spew out of your mouth is a goddamn lie. And you're mad that the Lord didn't choose you. You're mad that the Lord didn't choose you to be a man of the Lord, all right? You don't have this truth. The spirit, you come in the spirit of Saul, man. When Saul, he felt the spirit of the Lord get ripped away from him, man.
Dude. You niggas are mad that every time you look at our videos, we're a reminder that you was a bitch-ass nigga that quit.
That's right.
Because we still out there doing what you used to do before you stopped. We're out there still continuing on, and you're mad that we kept going and left your ass in the dust. We kept it moving forward just because you wanted to drop out with your transfer papers, all right? And now you're mad that we're still trying to make a progress and better ourselves and try to actually get salvation. You don't want us to do that. You want us to backslide like you did and somersault back into the world.
Yeah. You wanted to somersault, backflip, you know, cartwheel back into the world like you niggas, man. And you niggas are out of control. All right, but to the spirit and power, Yahweh Shemal Shai, we're going to continue to do the work. Brothers are going to continue to do the work. We're going to continue doing videos. We're going to continue to edify the elect because we're only here for the elect. We're here to curse you niggas out, all right? Bottom line, we're here to curse you niggas out and to tell you and to put on front your wickedness, all right? And that's why you guys are mad, okay? But to other brothers, we're going to keep pushing this word, all right, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemal Shai, all right, and edify the elect. And condemn the two-thirds, all right? Primarily you false prophets and teachers of Israel, all right? That come against the men of the Lord, all right? So with that, I hope brothers were edifying, and say Shalom.
Shalom.